the hard statement that we like to make and are working hard to engineering the system is that right now, if the system, if the service is working properly, nobody has access to your data. There is literally zero access, standing access, for human beings to your data if it's sitting in our cloud.
Compare that to the IT admin in a traditional IT shop where they are having long-standing permissions. So if I am an administrator, I'm going to be an administrator for every day of my life being an administrator. I have super powerful permissions. I can go and remove mailboxes. I can move them from one spot to the other. I can do all that stuff. But long-standing permissions are quite dangerous. What if they left the window open and somebody else came by and typed in the wrong command and did something dangerous? It is super, super interesting for us to go solve this problem, particularly online services, because our engineers do need the ability to go solve problems.
In the context of an incident where there's awareness across a number of set of people that that incident is going on in the service, then you can go to a set of that workflow that we call lockbox that through software allows you to request escalation to the predefined set of privileges for your role.
So what lockbox does is that it allows them the ability to elevate, and that ability to elevate, that approval, comes from somebody else in the environment. What I like to think about is when we design lockbox, it was kind of like the turning the two keys in order to go do something dangerous, right? So you have the president and you have the joint chiefs individually turning different keys in order to go take some severe action. We have the same philosophy in the data center.
There's always this holy grail of creating roles-based access control systems in both on-premise and in cloud systems. But there's a big difference between the machinery having access and the individuals working with to keep the service running having access to read your data. If you go after that, you can start building the system so that all the tools that are available to you are about diagnosing the health of the system and fixing it. And the machinery in doing that may in fact require read and write access to the underlying machinery, but the human being operating on the verbs doesn't have access to that.
It is impossible for one person to go do something serious like it is on the on-premise environment. On-premise is super easy for one person to be malicious. For that to happen in the online service, that's a conspiracy because you have to convince somebody else to be in cahoots with you in order to go turn the two keys.
As part of the process, the requests are logged, all the activities with those escalated privileges are logged, and those logs are reviewed by human beings and by automatic systems to try and detect interesting patterns.
Every single time somebody elevates, we know why they elevated, and we can pick out that behavior and say, ah, I know somebody who just did something invasive. It's really easy for us to tell the outliers. So a combination of the auditing and tracking, as well as the two turnkey system, as well as the very, very default roles, which really only give you troubleshooting access, combination of these three things for lockbox ensure that only the right people have only the right access at the right time and no standing permissions ever.